Welcome, Minneapolis Junior Senior High School fans. It's September 21, 2018, and we are here tonight in Ellsworth, Kansas at Shanilac Field on campus of Ellsworth High School for our fourth game of the season, our last league game, and our first district contest tonight of this 2018 season under the new format of the playoff districts. Minneapolis, the visitor tonight on homecoming night here in Ellsworth. It's a beautiful night, sun shining, the field looks to be in great condition. Breeze a little bit out of the north, but nothing like it could be. Current temperature is 70 degrees at kickoff, and the wind is out of the northeast at just a paltry 3 miles per hour. A perfect night for football. As your Lions start to come onto the field tonight, both squads are 2-1 on the season and 2-1 in the league. Ellsworth lost to Sacred Heart last Friday by a score of 9-7. And Minneapolis lost to Beloit by a score of 56-18, I believe. I didn't write that down. Both teams were undefeated coming into last week and faced their first loss. This is, as I say, the first district game, a common district for both squads. Very, what should be, hopefully, a winnable game for Minneapolis. Not that Ellsworth is going to be a pushover by any stretch of the imagination, but they're two teams that are very close in proximity, school size, squad size, and everything else. Common opponents, again, Ellsworth lost to Sacred Heart 9-7 in Salina. Minneapolis beat Sacred Heart 20-17 in overtime at home 2 weeks ago. Another common opponent, Minneapolis went to Belleville and beat Republic County 46-8 in the first game of the season. The following week, Ellsworth hosted Republic County and beat them 55-22 here at home. So, two very similar squads overall. This is the 48th game in the series. Ellsworth leads it 24-23. They've won the last three games in a row, and they've won 10 of the last 13. Minneapolis kind of domineered things for a little while with Ellsworth, but the last 13 years, Ellsworth has had the upper hand primarily percentage-wise. Leaders for the Bearcats are number 12, their quarterback, Morgan Kelly. He's got 226 yards passing, 186 yards, I believe, rushing. Their leading receiver is number 31, Travnicek, 188 receiving yards. That is rushing, 188 rushing yards. B. Schulte, number 23, 175 receiving yards. Their place kicker, number 6, Hernandez, has hit 8 of 9 extra points. So that's been pretty consistent for them. Looks like Minneapolis has won the toss and has declined. Ellsworth will receive and defend the north goal, which is on your left as you're viewing the field here. The left-hand side of the field is the northern portion of the field. It's a north-south orientation here at Shanilac Field in Ellsworth. The field looks to be in pristine condition. despite the rain that occurred yesterday. It's been well manicured. Looks like it's good football condition. 175-pound sophomore, number 15, Luke Sharp. The defensive backs tonight. So Minneapolis will kick off and defend the south goal. We'll be right back with the kickoff. Dale Leach for Eagle Communications, Channel 20. Okay, welcome back to Ellsworth as we're getting ready for the kickoff. One local connection here, a Minneapolis connection here in Ellsworth. A senior for the Bearcats, number 5, Jace Turnipseed. Wide receiver, defensive back. The son of J.C. Shoemaker. Turnipseed, grandson of former basketball coach Gerald Shoemaker. We'll see what Minneapolis does in kicking off into this 3-mile-an-hour wind. We've not really tried to kick it long throughout the season so far, at least that I've seen. Unless the wind picks up, it really shouldn't be a big factor tonight. Flag is high. Hanging limp to the south end of the field. Villapando and Hawk are in the center of the kickoff formation, as has been throughout the season. We've seen each of them kick, though Villapando the most. Villapando's number 22's Hawk. Two seniors. They gather up as usual, keep the receiving team guessing what they're going to do. Which man will kick, Villapando or Hawk? And it will be Villapando. And they're going to kick it down to the 18-yard line where it's picked up. Receiver breaks it out. I thought he was going to get tackled about 10 yards back, but number 15 gets it out to the 36-yard line, so about a 15-yard return. That was Luke Sharp, a sophomore. To start out a shotgun formation, three. Direct snap to number 3, Morgan Kelly, a junior.
Morgan Kelly on the keeper, brought down by Crew Martin.
Crew Martin with the stop. So it's a 2nd and 10 coming up for the Bearcats. Welcome, Scott Osherman.
Hi, Dale. Sorry about that.
No problem. Shotgun again. Kelly keeps it. Their leading rusher, he's got the first down and a little more. Up to the the Ellsworth, 48. Nice hole developed on the right side.
Brought down by Trent Meckel and Derek Peschel. That run is good for a Bearcat.
Kelly, not a big quarterback by any means, but he's got some speed. Direct snap to him again. He tries the right side, and this time he stood up. Got 2 yards, though.
Kelly on the keeper again.
Stopped again, he came in tonight being their leading rusher.
And Tristan Hawk. Gain of 2 brings up a 2nd and 8.
2nd and 8 from the middle of the field at the 50.
Ellsworth primarily a run offense, Dale.
Mm-hmm. Shotgun, he immediately turns and throws to the right, number 23, and has reception for the first down.
And they pass, just as I said.
That was Schulte, their leading receiver on the season.
Brought down by John Nelson. That reception's good for another Bearcat.
So Schulte is number
23. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So first down in line territory.
Tried option
nice
right.
Job. Caden McCulloch in the backfield drops him for a loss. Crew Martin in there as well.
Loss of 5 yards almost.
Loss of 4 on the play. Bring up a 2nd and 14. Splits one to the right, one to the left, one in the backfield in the shotgun. Drops back, he's going to throw again. Quick little slant, and he's going to have gain of about 7 on the play.
To Schulte again. Gets to the Minneapolis 33.
Actually, more than that, almost a 9.
Almost down to the 31.
11-yard gain.
Gave him a generous spot, I thought.
Very generous. Third and three.
Yeah.
Shotgun formation once again, offset eye. And a little bobbled snap. Oh, keeps it. He's going to have the first down at the 25 as the quarterback keeps it.
Kelly on the keeper, brought down by number 15, Derek.
Gain
Mitchell.
Of about 7.
With help from number 81, Hunter Allison. That run is good for another Bearcat.
So one to the right, one to the left, one in the backfield for Kelly. Drops back pass, he's going to throw across the middle. And
to Schulte again. Pretty spot on with his passes on those slants.
And they're just early quick slants. So
uh-huh.
Pass is complete again from Kelly to Schulte.
To both sides of the field.
Down by
2nd and 1 coming up.
Gain of 9, Hunter Allison in on that play. Schulte goes out to the left. One in the backfield for a shotgun. He's going to keep it himself. Ooh, has a nice block up there. No call.
There's a tackle on the flag on the tackle.
That's probably going to be a face mask then. Nope.
Pushing back.
Block in the back. So that's a block in the back. So that'll back him up.
10 yards from the spot foul. Probably. The foul occurred at the 19. So that will back them up. First penalty of the game.
Shotgun formation here on a long.
Another spot on slant pass, number 7 this time.
Good for a first down, a gain of 16 on that pass.
Grant Gwinner.
Brought down by Derek Pichel. That run was good. That reception is good for another Bearcat.
Gwinner with a reception there. So big catch right there on the outside. That was
2 first downs passing, 2 first downs running in this drive for the Bearcats.
And they're going to hand it off. And a nice inside tackle right there. Meckel in there as well as Tristan Hawk.
31 is the ball carrier. Travnicek, their leading rusher. 188 yards coming into tonight.
I thought you said their quarterback was their leading rusher.
Well, I'm sorry. I take that back. You're right. I did. He is. 226 yards rushing.
Still
pretty good.
This is
their second leading rusher.
Offset eye this time. And he goes back to that halfback. He stood up at the line. He gets to about the 10, maybe a gain of 2. Gets to about the 9-yard line. Maybe a gain of about 3 on the play.
Gain of 2 brings up a 3rd and 5.
3rd and 5 for the Bearcats.
.6:37 left to go here in the first quarter. Shotgun formation for the Bearcats. He's trying to drop back. Throws across and
slant.
Slant.
Good
for
inside.
Touchdown. 9-yard touchdown pass.
The number 7. That slant pass has been their bread and butter. Gwinner reception it there.
Low snap, kick is up, and it's no
good. Off the left field.
Off the left, so extra point is no good.
That makes him 9 or 8 of 10 on the season.
So
the Bearcats take the opening drive. A little over 60 yards. Started that at their 36. March down the field and score. 6:20 to go in the first. We'll be right back. Dale Leach and Scott Osherman for Eagle Communications, Channel 20.
Welcome back to Shanilac Field here in Ellsworth, Kansas, as the Minneapolis Lions trail early here, 6-0. Ellsworth will kick off back deep for the Minneapolis Lions. Is Derek Pischel and as well as the freshman, Gannon Cleveland. So as we get ready to go, they've kind of kicked away from Pischel all year. We'll see what this kicker does here as we get ready to go. I think he's got a little bit of a leg just from his extra point. And he does, he goes to Cleveland. And it's going to...
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds, yep. And so that will be a good spot for the Minneapolis Lions. So
we can re-kick it or bring it up to the 35.
I think that's a no-brainer. So and it looks like they will take it up to the 35. So so Minneapolis will take over at their own 35-yard line as we get ready to go here. I've liked our offense of late, Dale. We've had a little mix of a little bit of everything. This time we've got everyone boxed in fairly tight on this formation, one in the backfield, four Friel. Sends one in motion, and that is Meckel. He'll pitch it to Meckel. Meckel to the outside. He'll kick the outside. Kicks one up, goes through the next tackler. He should have enough for a first down. And he does at the 45-yard line. Nice job by Trent Meckel. Lions line back up here. As back to the same formation, Friel and shotgun. This time they'll send Pischel in motion. This time they pitch it out to Pischel. Got a lead block by, nice job there. Pischel is taking out of bounds. Ooh, that's really late there. No call. Nice job by Pischel. Another 9-yard gain as they get to the outside. Pischel with a nice run.
That's going to be just short of a first down, I do believe. Second and a half a yard here.
Have two receivers, one receiver out here to the left, one to the right, and both in tight though. They'll send Meckel back in motion. They pitch back to Meckel again. He goes back at the middle and he's hit hard at the line, but he's got enough for the first down as he cuts back in. Gain of 6 on the play, enough for a Minneapolis first down.
Gets to the Bearcat 39.
So Minneapolis is going to go right back to that pitch right, pitch left, make him stop us. So first and 10 inside Bearcat territory at the 39 and a half. McCulloch out here to the left with Meckel. Not sure who's to the right. We'll see here in just a second. They send Pischel in motion. This time they keep it himself. Friel does. And he'll be taken out of bounds at the 30. Another late hit there, no call. It gets up to the 30, gain of about 9 on the play.
Going to mark him at the 31. So second and short again for the Lions.
It's a gain of 8. will bring up a second down and short here. Villapando in the backfield. Pichel goes in motion. They go up the middle to
Villapando.
Villapando, and he'll have the first down. So they moved Tyson to a fullback this week, and looks like we had been seeing a lot of Tristan Hawk as the halfback. Tristan's had a little bit of injury, so they probably moved some players around a little bit. Tristan comes in now. Pichel McCulloch go out. So first down. Villapando gets the first down with the gain of about six. They'll send one out wide right. They throw across. They go out to Griffin. Griffin will have the first down. Nice job by Caden Griffin. Good pass. Enough for a Minneapolis first down. Gain of 13 on that pass. Nice job by the Lions here on this first drive.
Four first downs for the Lions on this drive. Three by running, one by the air.
Griffin goes back out to the right. Nelson out here to the left. Two slots this time. Villapando and Meckler are the slots. And Meckle. They go back up to Meckel with an inside draw. Somebody loses a helmet there, and it's somebody for Ellsworth. Not much of a gain. Maybe a gain of three on the play.
Yep.
Trent Meckel on the carry, brought down by Tyler.
Gain of two.
Short gain brings up a second and eight.
It's on the 12-yard
line.
Ellsworth. In the red zone.
Griffin goes out here to the far left. They'll send Villapando in motion, and they're going to run the option, but Friel's going to keep it, cuts it up, and he'll take it inside the 10 to about the 8-yard line, maybe the 7. Gain of about 5 on the play.
Third and 4 coming. From the Ellsworth 7, 3:50 to go here in the first quarter. Ellsworth scored on their opening drive. Minneapolis has turned suit and driving the other way. Let's see if they can punch it in here.
Griffin to the far right. McCulloch out here to the left. They'll send Villapando in motion, and they go Friel up the middle for a touchdown as he runs the option with the fake handle to the inside. Friel gets the touchdown.
Great fake to Hawk.
Nice job.
So a 7-yard TD run for Derek Friel.
At the 3:30 mark.
Kenny Kirk's in to try the extra point. So you can get Minneapolis the lead.
I think Nelson is the holder. Good snap. Ball's down. Kick is up, and it looks good. And I think it is. Nice job. PAT kick is good. Minneapolis goes up by one.
The score, Minneapolis 7, Ellsworth 6. With 3:30 here remaining in the first quarter, each team scores on its opening drive. Dale Leach, Scott Osherman for Eagle Communications, Channel 20. We'll be right back. Well, Scott, coming into tonight, I saw this as two very evenly matched teams.
Yeah.
And it's been very much on display
the first
two drives of this first quarter.
I kind of felt that coming in, just seeing that Sacred Heart had beaten them. Now early scouting, I didn't think they were a passing team at all, but man, they have passed the ball some. So they're all lined up within that 20 yards. They don't want to give up an onside kick. And they do kick it. So oh, it's still on the ground. Yes, it's still there. It's still moving. I don't know. We'll see who comes up with it.
Minneapolis players think they have it. Now the Ellsworth players say they have it.
Minneapolis has got it. Nice job as they get the kick on the onside. Nice job by the Lions. big one right there. They've gotten, I think, one every game so far this year, Dale. So that's just only three games still. Fourth game, so nice job of the Lions. So their second possession, they will start inside Bearcat territory at the 20-yard line. Big recovery. I don't know who came up with it for the Lions, but that's still a big recovery. Shotgun formation for Friel. Villapando is the fullback. They'll send Pichel in motion. They'll pitch out to Pichel. Pichel kicks it in, and he'll be taken down for a loss, maybe loss of one on the play.
At the 21. Yep, 1 yard loss.
Loss of one brings up a second and 11.
Pichel's got some good speed. He had a good game last week. Griffin goes out to the right.
Two touchdowns, one on rushing, one on a kickoff return last week.
Villapando is your fullback. Meckel and Pichel are your splits. They drop back. They're going to pull in the box, and Ellsworth's going to pitch it out to Villapando. Tyson's going to come up with some positive yardage there. Nice job as Friel saw he had nothing. And nice job. Villapando was kind of right there. They tossed it to him. He gets a gain of five on the play.
Friel was going down. Pitched it out to Villapando at the last minute. Third and seven coming up.
They'll send Griffin out to the right. McCulloch out here to the left. Villapando once again is your fullback. Pichel goes in motion. They will go to Villapando, and he'll be swallowed up at the 10-yard line. We'll bring up a fourth down and about five. That's not a very good spot.
Yeah, well, I thought they gave him the 15, but they're putting it at the –
Well,
yeah,
the down marker is, yeah, there you go. Yeah. The guy on the down marker is way off. Mm-hmm. He's not even paying attention. So it is a fourth and five, so gain of two on the play.
Going for it.
Why not?
Uh-huh.
Friel in the shotgun here on fourth and five. Pichel goes in motion. They drop back. They go out to – ah.
Nice breakup. They hit him when the ball got there. Ball was a little high, maybe, too. So Minneapolis turns it over on downs. Griffin, the intended receiver. Bearcats take over on there. 15. The score, Minneapolis 7. Ellsworth 6.
Shotgun formation, one to the right, one to the left. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. Oh, nice pursuit there. And they will drop him. Gain of one on the play. Quarterback gets to the 16-yard line.
Clock is down to under a minute now in the first quarter. 1 yard gain after the 16.
Cornett comes out.
Backus
comes in. One to the right, one to the left. One in the backfield for the Bearcats. Shotgun, they drop back. Inside the five, that would not be a penalty.
Yep.
They're yelling for it, but inside the five, there can be contact, and there was contact right there.
Cutting off that route. Don't give them free rein for that quick slant.
We're standing up here, and we're probably going to get unlike for our comment on that one. But third down and nine coming here. Griffin comes in for Allison. Third and nine, they're going to pass again.
Knocked away by Meckel.
Incomplete. So nice pass. Mm-hmm. Had a receiver right there, but it was.
Pass from Kelly is intended for Avery Haxton. Is incomplete. Brings up a fourth down.
Fourth and nine coming up from the Bearcats from their 16. Kelly, the quarterback, back to punt.
And he will punt it off, low kick, and Griffin's going to let it go. So
quite a bounce for the Bearcats. Gets to the 33 of Minneapolis.
That's where Minneapolis will take over. So punt. I know this officiating crew, Dale.
Is that good or bad?
That's good.
Good.
That's good. 13 seconds left here in the first quarter. Minneapolis up 7-6. They had a chance there, Dale, inside or right at the 20-yard line. They had it down to the 15-yard line but couldn't punch it in.
Bearcat defense stiffened.
Minneapolis does the same on the defense, and now we get it back at the 34. And Friel's going to keep it. He's going to cut up, and he'll gain of about three on the play, and that should end the quarter with Minneapolis in the lead.
It does. After one quarter of play, the Lions of Minneapolis lead the Bearcats of Ellsworth here on their homecoming 7-6 in a very evenly played first quarter. Scott Oshman and Dale Leach for Eagles Communications Channel 20. We'll be right back. Well, Scott, time to break out the jacket, the second jacket. I got a hoodie on. I thought about bringing something warmer, but you think my 66 years of wisdom would have told me to do so?
Well, I've got another jacket down there. I'll probably put it on here before too long. So
I should be okay, hopefully, with the hoodie and this second jacket. Slight breeze out of the north, but not too bad.
Not too bad. Bearcats here in their red and black. You probably already talked about that. Minneapolis in their traveling white and blue. Here at Shanahan Field. Beautiful area down in here. It's always just a beautiful facility down here. Kind of sits down low. Minneapolis comes back here to start the second quarter. One receiver, the right, one the left. Shotgun formation for Friel. And not sure.
Yeah, too much time or movement or something.
Maybe somebody didn't have a
There's a flag.
On. Yeah.
The illegal formation. False
Must
start.
Be, false start. Not sure. So it looks like he kind of was pointing that the center might have picked up the ball.
Probably. I mean, there was it's so quick and there was no movement.
Shotgun formation here on second and 13. And that should.
That's an encroachment.
That should back him back. So So are you keeping track of penalties?
Yeah.
Okay. So that should back him up. So it'll negate the one that Minneapolis had. Now we've got second down and 8. So one half does one way, half does the other deal. So back to the 37-yard line. Second and 7-6, something like that, for the Lions. Griffin out here to the right, Nelson to the left. Hawk is the halfback. Friel is your quarterback. Villapanda will go in motion. And they're going to – Friel's going to keep it, goes the outside. He's got some running room out there, cuts it back. In Xisto, he'll get the first down at midfield. A gain of about 14 on the play.
To the Minneapolis 49.
Nice gain. Gain of 13. Nice fake on that, Dale. Had everyone confused on that one as he rolls, fakes the handoff inside to Villapando. And we don't have anybody this year that's just an absolute burner that you can just focus on. But we've got a lot of kids that do a lot of different things. And we've been able to, so far, capitalize
Several
on different
weapons.
Kids doing different things. This time he's going to pitch it out to Pichel. Pichel's going to cut it up. He'll
get a couple 3 yards, maybe.
Should have forward progress to about the 49. They're going to say just the 50.
Yeah. 1 yard gain. Second 9. Actually, that's pretty good because I thought he was going to get for a loss. he was able to fight through it.
Yeah, gain of more than one. I thought he had a little bit more forward progress than that. But
1.5 yard gain.
Yeah, it's not that bad. 10:53, 7-6 Minneapolis with the lead. This time, McCulloch is your receiver out to the left, and Griffin is here to the right, but in tight. Meckel goes in motion. They're going to go.
Villapando,
and he's going to be swallowed up. No gain, maybe a loss on the play. We'll bring up a third and long. Or was that third down? No.
They're putting it almost a yard loss.
It's third down.
Third and nine coming up for the Lions.
Third and nine, so 10-18, third and nine. Minneapolis on their own 49-yard line. See what they got in their bag of tricks right here as they will come to the line of scrimmage. They're going to send Griffin out here to the right. McCulloch out to the left. Spreads out a little bit more. One halfback, two splits. They'll send Meckel in motion. And they're going to – oh, nice read by the linebacker.
Swallow up Creel.
And they swallowed him up for a loss. No blocking on that one, and Minneapolis loses five on the play.
Back to the 46 of Minneapolis. For us to punt.
Jace Turnipseed, that is a, his mother is a Minneapolis grad.
Yes. So. JC Shoemaker.
Should have given a trivia question on that one, Dale.
Well, I spilled the beans at the beginning of the game.
Oh, there's a flag. Come on. No flag on that? Yeah, that was terrible.
Ball gets down to the 12.
Tell me, Dale, why was there not a flag on that?
I didn't see it happen, but I did see him laying on the ground. Should have been at least an inadvertence, I would think.
Yeah, that's interesting.
I followed the ball, and when you said something, I looked back.
Yeah,
that's a mystery, Scott.
That was the actual punt was kicked by Meckel. And soccer style, it kind of rolls, rugby style kick, rolls the right and kicks.
Ellsworth 12.
Bearcats offset eye, and they go up the middle, and nice job of the Lions. I don't think he got anywhere on that. 31 the ball carrier, and maybe a gain of half a yard. Thompson with the tackle. Twins out here to the left. Two in the backfield with an offset eye. And quarterback's going to keep it himself. And he's going to be tackled. Nice job pursuit-wise by the interior line of the Lions.
He's got a yard or two maybe.
Oh, he got more than that.
Generous
spot on that one.
Third and five coming up.
So gain of five on that. Two come out. Minneapolis, they'll line it up here, third and five. There's motion there. And they're going to drop him. Nice job by the Lions right there. He's not going to get the first down. He's going to have forward progress to the 20, a gain of about two. Nice coverage by the Lions. We'll bring up a fourth and three.
Definite punting situation. Fourth and three from their 20 with 7:40 to go in the second quarter. Well, here's a trivia pursuit question for you, Scott. Who's the defending league champion in NCAA?
Football?
Yeah.
I don't know. Ellsworth?
Ellsworth.
There
yeah.
they are. I did not know that. Mm-hmm. So they're lining up like they're going to go for it here.
They try to draw us off. We don't watch it.
No, he did not get it. Nice job of the Lions. That is big right there by the Minneapolis Lions. And I don't think he got it.
No.
Minneapolis will take over on downs. Nice job. We'll see for sure where they spot it.
At the 21. Way short.
Big. Way short on that one. That is an interesting call, Dale.
Yes. That will be discussed by the Ellsworth fans for quite a while.
So Minneapolis takes over once again at their inside the Ellsworth 21. They had the ball at the 21 earlier. They couldn't punch it in. Let's see what they can do this time. 7:09 left to go here in the first half. Minneapolis with a lead 7-6. I formation for Friel. Hawk is your halfback. Villapando goes in motion. And he goes to Hawk. Hawk goes up the middle and has close to a first down. I don't know. He's awfully close. It looks like from the spot he might have it. We'll see for sure. It's for sure at least a 9, almost 10-yard gain. I think he's got it. We'll see for sure. It is first down, Minneapolis Lions. Hawk with his first carry, and it's a big one, 10 yards. Ball's on the 10-yard line now. Villapando goes in motion. And there, Friel's going to keep it himself. And nice pursuit by the outside linebacker. And they drop him for no gain.
Friel on the keeper brought down by Graham Gwinner.
Gwinner with the tackle
for the Bearcats. It's to the 10. Second and 9.
Sorry, gain of 1 brings up a second and 9.
Gain of 1. Minneapolis can still get a first down.
Oh, look, look at that sky.
Beautiful. Griffin out here to the right. I like Griffin's chances of going up in the air and taking one out of the air. And that's what it looks like they're going to pass. They go up in the air.
Intercepted.
And it is.
In the end zone.
Second time we have given it up inside their territory. And a big one right there. Costly mistake.
Ball was a little high over the head of the receiver.
Nice coverage and good interception by Ellsworth. The kid, he was the only one that could catch it, and he was able to.
Got his 1 foot down.
Ellsworth will take over at the 20. They will go up the middle and forward progress, maybe gets it to, I think they just get to the line of scrimmage. No gain. What scares me is they must have had some success up the middle as much as they are going up the middle.
Mm-hmm.
So, which makes me think if they get through, they've got some speed. So, Bearcats line up, one receiver out to the outside. They're going to throw. And they've got the receiver. Nice job by, I think, Crew Martin, possibly, with the tackle. Nope, Tristan Hawk with the tackle from the outside linebacker spot. Gain of 8.
Haxton, the receiver. 3rd and 2 coming.
Brought down by Tristan Hawk. Brings up a 3rd and 2.
Official timeout here. Or something. Letting the player come off the field with an equipment problem. His play card needs repaired.
Bearcats will come back out here. Two receivers to the left. And quarterback's going to keep it himself, and he's going to have the first down. Nice run there. Gain of about 5 on the play. First down. So 5-yard run by the Bearcats. Gets it out to the 33-yard line. Ellsworth's going to take a timeout. So we will go ahead and take one with them. Minneapolis with the lead, 7-6. Bearcats had the ball at the 33. We'll be right back.
4:43 remaining in the half.
Eagle Communication Channel 20. We'll be right back.
Okay, welcome back to second quarter action. 4:43 to go. Bearcats on the drive, 1st and 10 at their 33.
Play goes up the middle.
Hand off to 31, yep.
Gain of about four.
Three or four, yep. All of a sudden, the Bearcats are getting a little bit of running room.
Gain of three brings up a second and seven.
Offset eye once again for the Bearcats. Twins out here to the left. And quarterback's going to keep it himself, and he's going to take a seam at the middle, and he'll have enough for a first down. A gain of eight on the play gets it to the 45-yard line.
Faked the handoff, then followed his runner up the gut.
4:03 left to go here in the second quarter. Minneapolis clinging to a one-point lead. We've had some opportunities, Odale.
Yes. I hope those don't bite us.
I do too. One to the right, one to the left. Quarterback in a shotgun. One in the backfield. He's going to drop back to pass. He's got it up in the air.
And there's a penalty in the backfield, probably holding.
Legal procedure.
Illegal procedure, okay. It came quickly.
So a five-yard penalty will back him up, bring up a first and 15 at the 40. Bearcats will come back. Two this time to the left, two in the backfield. And quarterback's going to keep it himself. Nice read by Minneapolis. As
Martin
and Hawk, I believe, Villapando, great read by both of them. He gains one on the play, but still nice read by both of those guys.
Second 14 coming up.
Second and 14, as you said, one here to the left. And it's intercepted by Pichel. Nice job by Derek Pichel. And he's going to go down the side. And we got a penalty. Gosh darn it. It's going to be a holding right there. But still, we got the interception.
At about the 45 of Minneapolis.
The penalty flags at the 40. It's going to bring it back to about the 50. But still, an interception by Pichel. It will stand. It's just going to back us up. Nice read by Derek Pichel. Penalty was at the 40. Should be a 10-yarder. It is a hold. It is against the Lions. Should back him up.
To the 50.
So.
Stops that fourth Bearcat drive. Second turnover on the Bearcats on the night.
Nice job by Derek Pichel and the Lions. Now we just got to get something moving here on the offensive side. 2:52 left to go here in the half. Minneapolis at midfield. Griffin out here to the right. McCulloch to the left. Freel in a shotgun. Halfback is Villapando. Villapando goes in motion. They hand it off to him upside, inside. He'll take it to about the 45-yard line before he's swallowed up. Gain of four on the play. We'll bring up a second down.
Into Bearcat territory, 46-yard line. 2:30 to go in the half.
Griffin out here to the right. Friel in the shotgun. Meckel goes in motion. They will go up the middle to
Hawk. He gets to the 43, maybe.
Yeah, probably a gain of three on that.
Mm-hmm. 43-yard line of the Bearcats. 1:55 to go here in the half. Third and three for the Lions.
Griffin out here to the right. McCulloch is to the left. Shotgun formation for Friel. Drops back. He's going to pass.
Intercepted.
and he's got some running room. He could go all the way, and unless Friel can get him, I don't think he can, and that's
going to be about a 60-yard touchdown return.
Big interception right there.
Had nothing but green grass in front of him.
That really hurts going into the half right there.
And the
finish point is good.
Thirteen to seven, Ellsworth. I did not see who ran that back.
Travacek. And
Travacek, okay.
Let's see, I don't know. Travacek is number 31.
Okay, there's their running back.
So 13 to 7 here, 125 left to go in the second quarter. Big interception right there. So both teams have turned the ball over twice. We've not been able to capitalize on either one, and Ellsworth takes it back the other direction.
Both our turnovers are in there into the field, one in the red zone and one close to midfield.
Ellsworth will get ready to kick here. Back deep will be Pischel and Cleveland. We'll see what they do. Last time they kicked to Gannon, 125. Actually, last time it kicked out of bounds. So we'll see what happens this time. Kicker, the number 6, has got a leg on him.
Yep, Hernandez.
And he will kick it away. This one is going to go up the middle, and it's going to be taken by Cleveland, and he bobbles it, picks it up, and is going to be leveled at the 20.
Solidly met at the 20-yard line.
Yep. So, freshman, welcome freshman to high school football. So, there you get. So Minneapolis will take over at the 20. Filippando goes in motion. Friel's going to keep it himself. Cuts it up. Has the first down all the way out to the 34-yard line. A gain of 14 on the play. Nice job by Friel. Caden Griffin out here to the right. Friel keeps himself again. He's met hard at the line.
Got a yard or two.
I'm going to say two on that.
Yeah, gets to the 36.
Lions going to call a timeout. So Minneapolis will call a timeout to talk about this. So we'll take one with them. 58 seconds left here in the first half. Your Lions trail 13-7 here at Shanilac Field in Ellsworth, Kansas. We'll be right back.
Trailing by 6 from their 36-yard line.
58 seconds left here in the half. Shotgun formation for Friel. Griffin out here to the right. They're going to send Villapando in motion. Inside handoff. He goes, and he's still battling, but he's not going to get maybe to the 40-yard line. So a gain of 3 on the play. We'll bring up a third down.
To the 40. Third and 4, almost 5. 37 seconds remaining in the half.
Griffin out here to the right, McCulloch to the left. Shotgun formation. Griffin having a hard time holding on tonight. He does hold on to it, but it's not enough for a first down. Terrible spot.
He was at about. Terrible spot. He was at about the line to gain, but he was bobbling the ball.
Yeah.
And moved backwards. Timeout Ellsworth with 16 seconds remaining. We'll be right back. Welcome back here.
As Lions will come up. Fourth and two.
Fourth down.
They're going to punt the ball, and that is back is Meckle to punt.
Fake.
And they've got it's a wide open to McCulloch. McCulloch has had the first down. Nice job by Meckle to McCulloch, and we got the first down at the 30. Great fake punt. That's the advantage of having a punter that can throw the ball. Nice job by Meckle. Nice gain right there. I didn't see how far, all the way down to the 30, so about?
We were at
the 40, so a 30-yard pass completion. Mm-hmm.
8.5 seconds left, so we'll take a shot for the end zone, I'm sure.
And back, they'll send a couple there. Drops back.
Ah. Over the head.
And he's over the line of scrimmage, too. It's a good thing he didn't catch it. Whew. So 2.4 seconds left. I got lucky on that one, Dale.
Yeah.
So 2.4 seconds.
Of course, I could have sworn they would have called Ben Roethlisberger for that very same thing last week against the Chiefs. I never did hear the explanation for that.
So, and they've got a lot of cameras to prove it. So
uh-huh.
2.4 seconds left. Timeout by Minneapolis. 13-7 Ellsworth. Minneapolis at the Ellsworth 30. Trying to figure out a way to somehow punch a score in here with 2.4 seconds left. Minneapolis has had a couple opportunities, Dale. Both of them at the Ellsworth 21. We got to as close as the 10 and the 15, and we couldn't punch it in. One interception and one over on downs. Ellsworth has scored on the very first drive and then just ran a interception back for a touchdown. So Lions trying to somehow muster a way to tie it up going in here at the half.
We don't want to see another interception return to close the half here, that's for sure. So we must be careful whatever we do. This should be the last play of the half, barring a defensive turnover.
McCulloch is
the quarterback.
So a little different look. He's got maybe a little stronger arm. Might be the only thing there. Drops back.
He fumbled it, picks it up, and he's going down.
And that's a half. So that will end the first half.
The Bearcats leading our Lions 13-7. A very evenly matched first half play. We'll be back with second half action. I'll leave the camera on for the Ellsworth band a little bit. You don't see bands in high school performing much at halftime.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
Join their superhero halftime show. Today, the halftime show will consist of the Avengers, Batman, and the school fight song. Leading them is drum major Micah Bolton.
You ready?
No.
Oh, okay.
Almost.
Okay.
I got to get Ellsworth, so. Okay.
All right. Here's the stats here. Go ahead, Scott.
So for the Ellsworth Bearcats, they had four possessions.
They had five.
Five possessions. They 17 carries for 52 yards rushing, 4 for 7 passing for 37 yards, 1 interception. Their first drive was just beautiful. They basically took it down the field, passing, throwing, running easily, marched down the field on us. They scored easily. Minneapolis then was able to answer. We'll run through the stats for Minneapolis. Rushing-wise, 24 carries for 98 yards. We had some nice runs. We had 6 possessions, maybe 7, 6?
Six.
Six possessions, 24 rushes for 98 yards, 3 for 7 passing for 45 yards, but 2 interceptions, one of them a costly one that the Ellsworth Bearcats took back for a touchdown. Minneapolis twice had it inside the 21-yard line, actually had it inside the once inside the 10, the other side the 15, and both times, once an interception, the other one a turned it over on downs, and Ellsworth was able to capitalize on another interception for about a 60-yard return by Travichek, and that's your scoring. Minneapolis scored with a 8-yard touchdown run by Friel at the 3:30 mark in the first quarter. And the kick was good. So score at the half is 13-7.
As you said, Scott, 2 interceptions or 2 turnovers per squad in the half. Very costly for Minneapolis, and the fact that the interception returned to 60 yards for Ellsworth, and then we could not capitalize on the great field position we had on the fumble and the turnover, the interception. We had 8 first downs compared to their 6. They had 6 of our first downs were by rushing, 4 of theirs were by rushing. Each squad had 2 first downs passing. We had 2 penalties for 15 yards. They had 3 for 20. So pretty even in that regard.
Yeah. So at the half, 13-7, we got another half of football coming. We'll let you listen to the band, and we'll be back.
Welcome back with 3 minutes to go here for kickoff in the second half. Minneapolis should get the ball, I think, start since we declined.
Yeah, we should. So.
In the first half. This is a pivotal game in our district. Both teams very evenly matched. This is a win that's going to go a long way for whichever squad wins. Neither squad probably should hold up very well against Phillipsburg or Hoisington as far as odds are concerned. Two other games that could be possibly winnable for the Lions and maybe Ellsworth too would be Hayes, TMP, and Norton. Norton's not the squad they've been, I don't think.
No, and I don't know much about TMP either. I'm sure TMP plays some tough schools, so.
Well, they play Smith Center and Phillipsburg.
Yeah. So that's going to be kind of hard.
But they also play, and they play Plainville, I think. They're in that league anyway. Of course, they also play teams like Ellis and Trago County, some of the smaller schools. MCL is a tough league.
Yeah. So, you know, it's really, this is one that they definitely don't want to let slip away. They circled this one as a potential win, and I agree. And honestly, I felt like they won the first half, Dale.
Other than that interception return for 60 yards and not being able to capitalize on 2 turnovers deep in Bearcat territory. Goodness gracious.
Yeah, that's the part that really makes it tough, is that they've got to come out and got to come out and answer this here in the second half.
We'll be right back. All right, welcome back for the second half. It's 63 degrees here, kickoff in the second half, no wind at all. There was a little bit at the first of the game. Ellsworth will kick off from the south end of the end zone.
And it will kick to Cleveland at the 12-yard line. Comes up, and he's going to be taken down at about the 25-yard line. That's where Minneapolis will start. Nice kick. It's nice to have a kicker that can kick it deep.
Mm-hmm.
That's something.
We just took it for granted for so long, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. We did. So. Had the Yoxels for years, and that was. So Minneapolis will start here in the second half. McCulloch out to the left, Griffin out to the right. Freeland shotgun, looks like Hawk is the halfback. They'll send Villapando in motion, and they will go to him, and he will get it up to the 30-yard line before he's taken down. Gain of four on the play. Oh, darn it. Dale. You have to talk for me. I wasn't ready.
Gain to the 30-yard line, 4-yard gain. For Villapando. Second and six coming up for the Lions from their 30. I four pistol formation, I should say.
Fisher keeps it himself. Cuts it back up. He'll have.
Yeah,
he
first
down.
Down.
So,
yeah.
So that would be a gain of seven.
Derek Friel on keeper, brought down by Eric Andelin.
First and 10 from the Minneapolis 37.
Nice job by Friel on that quarterback keeper to the left. Comes back out here with a tight formation here to the right. Heavy to the right, heavy package. They're going to send Meckel in motion. And they're going to give the ball up the field to,
first
I think
down.
It's Villapando.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And it was Tyson, enough for a first down. Nice job by Tyson as he gets the nice run right there. Gain of 11 on the play will bring up a Lion first down. Ball on the Minneapolis 48-yard line. McCulloch out the left, Griffin out here to the right. See who goes in motion. And Villapando will go in motion. Inside, handoff, they go back to Villapando. And Tyson will gain about another 5 yards. Nice hard run by Tyson. We'll get it up to the Bearcat 47, gain
second
of five.
Second five coming.
Meckel and Villapando are in the slots. Shotgun formation. Villapando goes back in motion. This time they fake it, and Friel keeps it. He'll have the first down out to the Bearcat 40-yard line. Nice gain of seven on the play as he keeps it this time. Gain of seven. Another Minneapolis first down. 9:37 here in the first quarter. Minneapolis in Bearcat territory at Bearcat 39. As they'll come back to the line of scrimmage. Hawk is the halfback, fullback. In this situation, it's really the fullback. And you'd consider Meckel and Villapando your halfbacks. And this time they go to Hawk, and Tristan's going to get another almost 5 yards on the carry. Looks like maybe four.
And mark him at the 35.
So gain of four by Hawk.
Tristan Hawk on the carry, brought down by Brendan Tripp.
Just inside the 35. So second and a long five to go.
Shotgun formation. Villapando goes in motion. And they go back to him. And Tyson will be close. Gets it about the 30-yard line. Gain about three.
Got it marked just outside the 30.
Can be about a third and two.
Oh, yeah. Right at the 31. 32.
Yeah. So gain of two on the play.
It's not where the line judge was lined up on this side, but the guy on the other side was different.
The guy that's carrying the box has not been accurate where he stands tonight. It's been all over the place. Supposed to keep with that official, and he has not. Third down and three. Friel's going to keep it. Cuts up. Ooh, nice read. He'll get
nowhere.
Anything.
Got maybe a yard. Gets to the 31 of Ellsworth.
Fourth
and
down.
One. A long one.
Fourth and long here. 7:37 in Bearcat territory at the 31. Shotgun formation.
And try to draw him off. The hard count.
Timeout Ellsworth. So Ellsworth calls the timeout. That's interesting. So Ellsworth calls the timeout. Both teams held their own. So timeout Ellsworth. Minneapolis will have a chance to kind of chat about this. Ellsworth kind of gave him a little bailout.
Right because that would have been our move here short, pretty quick, was take a timeout. We'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. There's 7:15 to go here in the third quarter. Minneapolis started out this drive on their 26-yard line. They've moved it down to the Bearcat 31. It's fourth and one.
Fourth and one. They've put the fullback as Villapando. Pichel moves into a slot with Meckel. Fourth and one, long one, maybe two. Shotgun formation. Ellsworth gets up in a tight box. Pichel goes in motion. And yeah, Friel's going to keep it. He'll have it. Nice job by Derek Friel. Has enough to get it. Nice job by Friel to get the first down. And nice job by Friel.
Ran into his blocker. I'm glad that didn't throw him off too much.
Yeah, too. That was kind of scary there for a second, Dale, as he had a nice little seam there, but then ran right into Villapando.
So first and 10 at the Bearcat 27.
Friel goes back into a fullback. This time Meckel goes in motion, and they're going to pitch it out to Meckel. Meckel's going to cut it up, and he'll get to the 25-yard line. Gain of about, not quite the 25, so gain of two maybe on the play.
Kenny Kirk on the carry.
Just outside the 25.
Well, Kenny Kirk said they had to carry, but it was actually Meckel. So nice job, Kenny Kirk. So
second and eight from the 25.
Kenny gets his Kenny's
multi-purpose player. Yeah, multifaceted.
Shotgun formation for Friel here. Second and eight. Pichel goes in motion. And Friel, nice little running room right there. Oh, he's got really good room. Cuts it back in. Still on his feet. Still going. We got a flag, though. Oh, man, that's going to be costly. All the way back at the 30.
Oh, wow, yeah. So the hanky is.
He's got another hanky at the 20. So
might be offsetting. Run it again.
Holding against the Lions. Ah, that stinks.
See if the white hat's going to sort out here.
We have another flag right there, so it is against the Lions. So is holding against the Lions.
Holding is the call against Minneapolis. And that's going to back them up a little bit.
Moves us back to the, well, that's interesting. It's pushing the back. It was that the flag was at the 30. They gave us a 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, it is. So what would have been first and goal now is second and a long 18
on the clock.
5:57 backs us all the way up to the Bearcat 35. Twins out here to the right. Second and long. Meckel goes in motion and pitches it outside to Meckel. And he'll take it down to the 30-yard line. Gain of about 5. And it'll bring up a long.
Third and 12. Just inside the 30.
Third and 12. Friel's going to have to hurry on this. He took a little bit of time at the sidelines. So Griffin out to the right. McCulloch out to the left. One goes in motion. Going to drop back. Ah.
Way outside on the pass attempt. At least there was nobody out there covering.
It's fourth down.
Fourth and 12 coming up.
This is where we hold them.
From the 30.
This is where we fight. This is where we hold them. This is where we fight.
And McCulloch is going to switch to quarterback in this situation. So, but they're going to really run close on time here, Dale. Fourth and 12. McCulloch goes into the quarterback spot. One the right, one the left. McCulloch drops back to pass.
Knocked away. Hey, was that 8 out there, the tended receiver?
No, that was Matt.
Caden McCulloch with the pass is incomplete.
Thought it was Meckel, but maybe it is Kenny Kirk.
Intended for Trent Meckel.
Yeah.
Okay, so we drive to the 30-yard line from our 26 and turn over on downs.
First and 10, Bearcats.
Bearcats take over at their 30. Leading 13-6. We took a lot of time off the clock. It's down to 5:27 remaining in the second quarter, third quarter.
Twins to the left for the Bearcats. Offset eye for the Bearcats. They will hand it off. And nice tackle right there. I believe Colton Bradford.
Nice hole for the Bearcat runner.
Colton Bradford gets in there for the tackle. But a big gain of 8 on the play. Mm-hmm.
Second and 2 coming up from the Bearcat 37.
They will fake the handoff. Quarterback's going to keep it himself, and he's going to be driven up.
He should have it.
Yeah.
They're marking him at the 41, which is beyond the line to gain.
Kelly on the keeper, brought down by Drew Martin.
So gain of 4. First down. So a lot of time taken off here in the third quarter. Trips this time to the right for the Bearcats. Shotgun formation. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. Goes up the middle. And, oh, ball's on the ground. And we've got it. Nice job by the Lions. We got the fumble recovery. And it will go back the other direction. Nice job by John Nelson. Falls on the ball with the turnovers. Dale, we have got to capitalize on one of these three turnovers.
We just got to, you're right. At the Ellsworth, 47.
So Minneapolis takes over. Second possession of the half. Shotgun formation. Filippando goes in motion. And he keeps, and the ball's on the ground. We fumble it this time. Ah, dang it. Please tell me we recovered. I think Tristan Hawk recovered it. Wow, we got lucky there, Dale.
Yep, very fortunate. A gain of five. Almost five. Second and six here for the Lions. 3:58 to go in the third quarter.
Caden Griffin out here to the right. McCulloch to the left. Shotgun formation. And we're going to have a timeout. Timeout called by the Lions, so we'll take one with them. 13-7, Ellsworth with the six-point lead yeah. at the 3:47 mark here in the third quarter. We'll take a break as well. You're listening to Eagle Communication Channel 20. Dale Leach and Scott Osherman. We'll be right back. One to the right, one to the left. Shotgun formation for Frio here on second and five, maybe six. Pichel goes in motion, and Frio's going to keep it himself. Oh, my goodness. The linebackers are drilling him badly.
Got to the 41 of Ellsworth. Third and about four to go.
Caden Griffin out here to the right. We have not had a passing game so far tonight. Shotgun formation. Pichel goes in motion. They go up the middle to Hawk,
and he's going to.
No, that is not Hawk. That was number 23, Crew Martin.
Oh, okay.
Crew Martin with the carry, and Crew gets the first down.
We saw the two at the beginning of the.
Gain of five.
Digit, first down, Minneapolis.
I'm not going to have a spot to put little Crew's name in here. So.
3:03 remaining here in the third quarter. Ball's at the 37 or 36. 36, actually, of Ellsworth.
Twin to the right this time. Pichel goes in motion. And they pitch it to Pichel. Pichel cuts up. And nice read there by the Bearcats. Pichel's taken down at the 32-yard line. Only a gain of three. You know, on the option, it sure looks like we get more yardage, but you're taking up a lot of yardage on the pitch. So.
Four yard gain, second and six coming up. Hawk comes in. Martin goes out.
2:06 left to go here in the third quarter at the 31-yard line. Second and six. Griffin to the left. McCulloch to the left. Pichel and Villapando are in the slots. Filippando goes in motion, and they go to Hawk, and they do throw a flag.
Yeah, there was.
Yeah,
the
there was definitely,
tackle,
definitely.
Left tackle on us in motion, or so. Illegal procedure.
Legal shift. I thought what I saw was both Filippando and Hawk, and Hawk started to go forward on that, and I think that's what they saw. I don't think they saw the tackle. Either way, it's 5-yard penalty. Bring up a second down and 11.
And put the ball at the 36. 1:45 to go here in the third. Scoreless third quarter so far.
Lions will come back up here. 1:34 left to go in the third quarter. Minneapolis trying to. We've had some opportunities tonight, Dale. We've just got to somehow figure out a way to capitalize on them. One to the right, one to the left. Hawk is your halfback.
Try trying to get them to jump off.
This time Pichel goes in motion, and they will go to Hawk, and Hawk is going to still lumber forward. Nice job, Tristan Hawk, as he will get all the way up to the 28-yard line. Nice job by Tristan. A gain of about eight on the play.
Short of the first down. I almost thought we were going to have a new legal procedure again.
Gain of eight will bring up a third and three.
Third and three at the 28 of Ellsworth.
42 seconds left here in the quarter. At the 28. Heavy package to the right. Friel sends Pichel in motion. And Friel's going to keep it. Oh, he's not going to get it. Not going to get it, Dale. That's a terrible spot, but I don't think he's going to get it. This guy's got a pretty good spot, but that's that guy back there did not spot it very well.
Brings up a fourth and one. Fourth and one from the 27. And the clock is going to expire here
on the third quarter. So at the end of the third quarter, Minneapolis still trailing by 6, 13-7.
And that ends your third quarter. We'll be back with the final quarter. In just a minute, Dale Leach, Scott Osherman, Eagle Communications, Channel 20.
We're careful here, so.
All right, fourth and one from Minneapolis at the Bearcat 27 at the start of the fourth quarter. This is the second possession of the Lions of the half. Bearcats have just had one possession. Pichel keeps it. He's got the first down. Or not Pichel, Friel.
So, nice job, and a nice little gain as well. A gain of three on the play.
Gets it to the 21.
So, Minneapolis does get another fourth down. We've had a couple tonight. Yard line. Caden Griffin out to the right. McCulloch out here to the left. Hawk is your halfback. Pichel's in a slot to the right. Friel's going to keep it, and he's just going to get up to the 20. Not much of a gain, Dale. Maybe two. I'll tell you, that official has not spotted the ball very well tonight.
Get it to the 21.
Wow.
Half-yard gain. Second nine coming up.
Going to have to ask who was the head lines judge, because it has not been pretty. I think they switched positions, but switched around. So anyway, Filippano goes in motion, and Hawk bounces out, and nice pursuit. Nice pursuit and nice tackle in the backfield. Hawk was swallowed up. Loss of three, four on the play.
Collision between Hawk and Friel on the handoff. And he got bottled up there immediately. Hawk bounced, tried to bounce to the outside. Was tracked down immediately for the 4-yard loss. Third and 14 coming up.
Third and long here. Ball on the 25-and-a-half yard line. Keaton Griffin out to the right-hand side. McCulloch comes out here to the left. Shotgun formation. Hawk is the halfback. Pichel and Villapando are in the slots. Villapando goes in motion. They're going to drop back to pass. Throws it up in the air.
Good defense.
Bring up a fourth down.
Griffin was the intended target. Well covered by the Ellsworth defender. Fourth and 14 coming from the Bearcat 25.
Friel will come back here, fourth down and 14 coming here. 4:52. Hey, we've got Mr. Noah Helgett coming up here. We'll get a headset for him just in a second here.
9:52 to go here.
One to the right, one to the left. Filippando goes in motion, drops back to pass, throws it up in the air, has Griffin out there, and he's caught it.
Oh, not a touchdown.
It's not a touchdown, but he does catch it, and it's at the one-yard line. Nice catch by Caden Griffin.
That was
nice pass up in
throw.
The air. Good throw. This time it is a completion of 24 yards. Nice pass, nice completion.
Let's take care of that after this sequence here.
Minneapolis will have a first and goal at the one-yard line here. Nice pass by Friel, probably his prettiest ball of the night. And it was up in the air enough that Caden could go after it. Good catch by Griffin. First and goal at the one. Pichel goes in motion. Ball's on the ground.
And we fumble it. Go back to the five.
Loss of four. Ball will come up back here on a second and goal for the Lions. 8:56 left to go in the ball game. Bearcats with the lead. Friel in the shotgun. Pichel goes in motion. And he's going to be taken out of bounds.
Pitches,
another loss.
Pitches it at the last second to Pichel.
And another loss. This is a loss of seven on the play. Wow.
Back to the 7. 2-yard loss. Third and goal from actually the 8-yard line.
So third and 7. We've gone backwards on two consecutive plays. Third and long here. Now you've got a little bit more difficulty here. Now you've got more of a passing situation in here. This time they'll send Pichel in motion. They will go to Villapando, and he's going to be swallowed up right there as well. Maybe a gain of no gain. Back to the line of scrimmage. Ellsworth defense, Dale, has really tightened up right here. Nice job by their defense. 4th and 7.
No gain brings up a 4th and 7.
4th and goal from the Ellsworth 8-yard line, looks to me like. Clock says a 7. But.
This time they will line up with McCulloch out to the left, Griffin out to the right. Villapando in the shotgun. They'll send Meckel in motion. Drops back, throws it up in the air. Has McCulloch, nice job.
Got
touchdown
it.
Minneapolis as he goes up in the air to McCulloch for the 8-yard touchdown.
8-yard
pass.
TD, yep.
So nice job as they get it to McCulloch for the touchdown. That ties it up at 13 right here. Minneapolis will come in, Kenny Kirk, to try to kick the extra point to try to give us the 1-point lead. Nice job by the Lions to finally capitalize on a turnover. Kirk to kick the extra point. Ball's down, kick is up, and it's up, and it is. No. Good.
Oh,
I thought it was wide
to
the right.
Like
I thought it was
right.
Wide right, but
looked
it falls
to me like
in.
It
so
to the right.
PAT kick is good. Minneapolis takes the 1-point lead.
7:46 to go in the fourth quarter. We'll be back for the Minneapolis kickoff. Okay, Minneapolis has the 14-13 lead with 7:46 to go here in the fourth quarter. And we'll be kicking off.
You can have it down. As we're joined by Noah Helgett. Noah is a high school senior here at Minneapolis High School, and he joins us up here at the box. Noah has some desires to do a little radio and a little broadcasting. He is the voice of the Minneapolis Lions when it comes to the junior high football as well as volleyball, which he did a great job last night. Minneapolis to kick. I'll talk more in a second. As Tyson Villapando to kick, and they will kick towards the sidelines, and it will be recovered this time by the Bearcats at the 23-yard line. So Noah, you're joining me. I'm going to make you talk. So tell us a little bit about you're a hometown boy. You moved away for a couple years.
Yep.
Went to Wamego.
Yep.
Glad to have you back. You're active in what? Tell us about it.
Well, yeah, I moved away to Wamego for 5.5 years and came back. Had to come back. Excited to graduate with my graduating class. So that was really nice.
Absolutely. As the Bearcats will come back to the line of scrimmage here on first down at the 24-yard line. They will give it to the halfback. He'll go at the middle. Bounces off one tackle. Still on his feet. Wow.
Fumble?
No. He got all the way out to the 31. Nice run there by the halfback. They had him. Travichek had him in the backfield, but he's a little bit squirmy. He gets a gain of 7 on the play.
Out to the 30 of Ellsworth. Second and 4.
So, Noah, you've done some broadcasting as far as announcing from the booth. I heard you last night
at
high school volleyball. You did a very nice job of really encouraging our Lady Lions. And then when you announced the Solomon, it was very monotone.
Yep.
Very nice. I was very impressed with that. So, trips out here to the right for the Bearcats. Shotgun formation. They'll drop back. They're going to look to pass, but they keep it. He'll have the first down. Quarterback keeps it. Gain of 5 on the play as they open it up a little bit.
Now we need a turnover again.
Kelly on the keeper, brought down by Crew Martin and Cooper Thompson.
That would be very encouraging.
First down.
Clock is winding at 6:40 here, remaining in the fourth quarter. Bearcats are at their 35-yard line.
Trips out here to the right once again. Shotgun formation, one in the backfield. They're going to drop. They're going to pass quickly out here to the right. There's a hold right there. How is that not called? No call. They will have the ball at the 42-yard line. And since we're on Minneapolis, we can be a little bit of a homer up here as well. As long as we're not too terribly bad, that was a 5-yard pass completion. Gain of 5 will bring up a 2nd and 5. That's one of the things that Minneapolis is going to have to watch, giving up those little 5-yard outs. Shotgun formation. 2 go in motion, no call. And they will give it to the halfback, and he's still on his feet.
Got the first down.
First down all the way to the 50-yard line. Big run by the Bearcats as they gain 9, enough for a first down. Dale, I have a feeling that their kicker can maybe kick a field goal, too.
I would say if they got down in the 10-yard line, 15, he possibly could make it.
I'd say maybe even the 20. So twins to the left, 2 in the backfield for the Bearcats. He's going to keep it himself, and he will.
Into Minneapolis territory.
At the 45-yard line.
They're moving the ball with a lot of ease on this drive.
Gain of 4, almost 5, 5:17. The clock can't go fast enough.
Minneapolis Lions need a big stop here. Turnover would be wonderful. Homecoming night for the Bearcats.
One way to hopefully spoil it, twins to the left. Minneapolis tight on the defense. Quarterback's going to keep it himself, and he's going to have another gain of 2 on the play. Pichel and Villapando in on the stop.
They're getting some nice holes in the line for him to squirt through. Gets to the 42 of Minneapolis. 3rd and 2.
4:38 left to go. 14-13 Minneapolis with the 1-point lead. They have used their quarterback a ton tonight. He is their workhorse. He does a lot. He twins out to the left-hand side. 3rd down and 3. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. Oh, nice little run up the middle, and he's going to have the first down all the way up to the 30. Nice block. Bearcats open up a hole there, Dale, and wow, big run by the Bearcats. Not what the Lion fans want to see right here. Minneapolis defense is going to have to tighten it up right here.
That run is good for another Bearcat.
First and 10 at the Lion 30.
10. Twins to the left. Offset. Quarterback's going to keep it himself again. This time he will hits another 5 yards, Dale. I'll tell you, he is a workhorse. He's not that terribly big, but, man.
For his size, he's a real workhorse.
He is a real workhorse. Gain of almost, I'm going to say, six.
He's down to the Minneapolis 24. Yeah, it was six.
Gain of six brings up a second and four. Lions have got to muster a stop here, Dale. Twins to the left. Shotgun offset eye for the Bearcats. He's going to fake, keeping himself, and he'll get up to the 20-yard line, and that's going to be close. They have been what I feel very generous with the Bearcat spots, and they have been very questionable on the Lion spots tonight. I think they'll be short
about
by
a half
yard
short,
so.
Oh, they're going to measure. Official timeout.
So while they're measuring, we'll talk with Noah a little bit more. So plans next year for school?
Well, I'm planning on going to Cloud County.
Okay.
I've been interested in the broadcasting, so I've talked to, of course, Scott and Dale a lot about it. But I know they have a great broadcasting program up there, Toby Noster, of course, voice of Concordia. So I've always enjoyed talking about sports. It's always been a passion of mine. Not exactly on the field playing them, of course, but.
And you have a nice knowledge, and you have a good voice. I will compliment you on that. You got a great voice and have a great potential with it. Dale and I Dale's done a lot longer than me.
Stumbled into it. First down for the Bearcats at the Minneapolis 20.
That's a very good point. Stumbled into it is a very good, very, very good point for me. So first and 10, ball on the 20. 3:08 in Minneapolis territory. Shock information for the Bearcats. Garrett quarterback keeps himself. And there, Dale, we cannot
he
stop
just scorched
it.
Through there.
It's a gain of 5 to 7 every single time.
Yeah,
six,
seven yard gain, almost eight.
They have moved this thing with ease on this possession.
.239 and counting. Eating up a lot of time on the clock.
Yeah. And moving the ball very easily. So, shotgun formation once again. There we finally drop him in the backfield. Great job by Minneapolis as Villapando, as well as Hunter Allison in there. And Gaten Heald, a bunch of kids in on there. A loss of 4 on the play. Nice play.
3rd and 8 coming up.
2:03. To me, Ellsworth would be really not. They'd be just smart to keep it in the quarterback's hands. He's their most sure-footed runner and handler of the ball. I would love to see him not, but they're going to send Trips out here to the right. They've got Trips out here. They're going to have to watch that little quick pass. Drops back. They're going to throw quickly to the outside. And, great job by the Lions right there as Tristan Hawk and Trent Meckle in on the tackle. And they will bring up a 4th and 8.
It's a very key stop there.
Gain of maybe 1 on the play.
Well, they don't trust him for the field goal, Hernandez.
4th and 8.
Oh, yeah, they do. They're going to bring him on for a field goal, too.
But this angle is going to be tough. This is going to be a tough angle for him to try to kick.
It'll be a 34-yard attempt.
He's got the leg. High snap. Kick is up. No, it's not good.
No good.
Nice job. It's short and to the left. Big, big play right there.
59.6 seconds left on the clock.
Ellsworth has 2 timeouts left. So they can stop the ball.
We can't just necessarily kneel on it.
No. So 59.6 seconds left. Minneapolis is going to have to hold on to this and not turn it over. Be smart with it.
Got to move the clock as much as possible between their timeouts. You know the timeouts will be coming.
Griffin out to the right. McCulloch out here to the left. Hawk is your halfback, or fullback. They will send Pichel in motion. They will go to Pichel. And they will get to the 20. And they do not call timeout. I do not understand
that. I don't either. That's amazing.
Wow. That is so interesting, Dale. That just blows my mind because I believe they have two timeouts left.
Yes, they do.
Why they would not call that right there.
I mean, because we're going to take all the time we can between plays.
Yeah. Now, they will have – they can call two more timeouts, though, so that will be to their advantage on this one. Pichel. They will go back to Pichel, and he will have the ball up to the – there he calls a timeout – up to the 26-yard line. A gain of seven – six.
Second timeout of the half by the Bearcats. We do move the ball to the 26-yard line where it's third and four. We have 15.9 seconds to waste two downs with, Scott.
Yeah, but
there'll be one timeout called.
One timeout called. And it'll be fourth down. Yeah.
We get a first down, it's over.
It's over, but yeah.
Yeah, I'm just bamboozled that they didn't call an
immediate timeout.
Immediate timeout after that first play.
15.9 seconds, 14 to 13. Whew, don't you? Get your old blood pressure going.
Crazy.
Get your old blood pressure going up here, Noah. So it's hard to do. Thank you so much for coming up here, buddy. You're welcome anytime. I'm welcome. You maybe Dale won't, but I'm telling you.
Yeah, I appreciate it coming up here.
And. Good way to cut your teeth and to have a little fun with it as well. We're tape delayed on Eagle Communication Channel 20. Mm-hmm. So 15.9 seconds left.
No mistakes, no fumbles.
Friel is, send Pichel in motion.
He has the speed.
Pichel gets the outside. He is not going to get there. And that's going to be the last timeout. 10 seconds. We'll bring up fourth down. So, let's see. On the change of possession, so we're going to have to punt.
Clock will stop with the change of possession. So,
we will almost have to punt here, Dale.
That would be the very safe thing to do, yes. Very safe thing to do.
So 10 seconds left, 14 to 13.
Actually, I have seen, don't we kind of rugby kick?
We do.
Punt?
Yep. We do.
So we could take a few seconds off by running the ball forward before we kick, and that would help.
Meckle gets them off most of the time.
Yeah, going to have to make sure that they no penalties, no blocking. They're going to send the house at him, which you would pretty much expect. High snap, and this kick is off there. That's going to help
us
a bunch.
Punt.
Wonderful punt, and that's going to roll all the way down. That's going to be the ball game, guys.
3, 2, 1.
So 0.7 seconds left. 0.7 seconds left. They will have a play.
At the 25.
At the 25. So put somebody back in center field. 0.7 seconds left. Minneapolis could come away with their third win of the year, but most importantly, a win in district. That could be huge. This will be another Ellsworth lost a one-pointer last week to Sacred Heart, I believe.
Yep.
It was a one-point
loss.
No, it was
two.
2 points.
9-7.
So timeout's going to be called by Minneapolis.
Our second timeout of the half.
So in this situation, I'm assuming they're going to throw it up. Either that or they're going to lateral the ball numerous times.
Yeah.
Try to lateral it and try to break open for one. Anything's possible. You just got to somehow get in and get a get them stopped.
Let's see
here.
The old hoop and lateral like Minneapolis did last week. Hook and lateral, I should say.
Yeah.
So, which is the most weird hook and lateral I've ever seen.
Yeah, that was that was pretty sweet though.
Going to Gaten Hill.
14-13, 0.7 seconds left. Ellsworth has the ball at their own 25. And that will basically one play unless there's a penalty.
Yeah, can end on a defensive penalty.
So they will send back deep is going to be Colton Bradford and Caden Griffin, Pischel, and they're going to leave them wide open. They're just going to have to make sure they get an open field tackle. The quarterback, they will throw it up.
Do the lateral.
Yeah, there we go. Nice job. It's still on the ground.
Fumble.
Yeah, there we go. That's the ball game. And Minneapolis comes away with the victory here on homecoming. What a nice victory for the Minneapolis Lions. Another tough defeat for the Ellsworth Bearcats as Minneapolis comes away with the victory on the road in district play, 14-13 Minneapolis Lions.
Break a three-game losing streak to the Ellsworth Bearcats.
We'll be right back with some stats. You're listening to EVE Communication Channel 20. Welcome back to Ellsworth, Kansas. Shanelac Field here. Ellsworth, Kansas. Minneapolis comes away with the victory 14-13 as the Lions go to 1-0 in district, 3-1 so far in the season. Nice job by the Lions. For the Ellsworth Bearcats, 3-for-3 passing in the second half for 12 yards, 13-63 on the ground, most of it done by their quarterback. They did not score in the second half. They had a fumble and a missed field goal. For the Minneapolis Lions, 2-for-5 passing for 32 yards, the most important one coming on a 24-yard pass down to the 1-yard line, and then an 8-yard touchdown pass to Caden McCulloch. Running-wise, 25 carries for 72 yards, a lot of that done by multitude of players, Friel, Villapando, numerous players in on that. Pischel, Minneapolis comes away with the victory 14-13 here at Ellsworth, Kansas.
15 first downs for Minneapolis, 11 for Ellsworth. We had 4 penalties for 25 yards, Ellsworth 3 for 20 yards. They had no penalties in the second half that I recorded anyway.
We're going to run down.
All right. But very much needed win here. First opening game of district, Minneapolis coming away with the 14-13 win on against Ellsworth on their homecoming night. As I told you at the beginning of the game, it's going to be very even. Should be very even, and that's the way it turned out. Two very balanced squads. Each team scored on their opening drive, and then it was a lot of defense from then on, and many and Ellsworth scored a 60-yard TD return on defense to get their last score of the night. Each team got dangerously close. Minneapolis finally capitalized. So, very exciting game. Hope you've enjoyed it here on Eagle Communications Channel 20. Next Friday, we'll be at home to take on the visiting Norton Blue Jays, I believe, at homecoming activities. And so we'll see if the Lions can somehow go 2-0 in district play tonight or the after a game next Friday on homecoming night. So with that, Dale Leach, Scott Oshman, and
Noah Helgett
are going to sign off. Thanks again for always has for having us in your homes. We do appreciate you watching us. Good night, folks.